So we showed earlier that this was 1 over k, 1 over the size of k. Now we've shown that the probability of m equals m star is equal to the probability the message is m star divided by k. So we've shown these two things. Now we just need to plug them into our conditional probability formula. We're going to have this on top, and we're going to divide that by the probability of b, which is 1 over k. The over k's will cancel out, leaving us with the probability that the message is equal to m star. And that's exactly our definition of a perfect cipher. So we can conclude that the one-time pad is a perfect cipher. It exactly satisfies the definition of a perfect cipher, where the ciphertext reveals nothing at all about the key. So you might think the class should be over. We've achieved our goal of perfect secrecy using a cipher that was invented over 100 years ago and is actually provably perfectly secret. So we're not quite done yet. There's some pretty serious problems with the one-time pad. One problem is that it's malleable. So what malleable means is if Alice sends her ciphertext to Bob and our evil interceptor, this time it's not just an eavesdropper, it's an eavesdropper with a hammer. If our interceptor has control over the network, and instead of just being an eavesdropper, can be an active attacker. And an active attacker means they can actually change messages on the network. So the message that arrives at Bob is not C, it's C prime. Because it's a perfect cipher, the attacker can't learn anything new about the message from C, but she could modify it. And maybe she had a pretty good guess about maybe there was a number in the message somewhere or something that she wanted to change. Well, she could flip the bits at that part of the message, change the ciphertext that Bob receives to C. It would decrypt, and with the one-time pad, encryption and decryption are the same function. The decryption of C prime would be M prime. And the attacker can actually control the difference between M and M prime, because the way the one-time pad works is just XOR. So the attacker could decide whatever difference she wants to introduce in the message. This is a dangerous property for a cipher to have. Another big problem with the one-time pad is that it's very impractical. And the real reason that it's impractical is because the keys have to be as long as the messages, and we can never reuse the key. So this is this property that the number of possible keys is equal to the number of possible messages. So maybe what we should try to do is to find a more practical perfect cipher. Unfortunately, Claude Shannon proved that that's not possible. So that's what we're going to look at next, is why this property that the key space has to be at least as big as the message space is a requirement for a cipher being perfect.